In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the voting history data in Survivor to build a dynamic network for network analysis in Gephi. The data I'm going to use here come from Survivor Season 45 Wikipedia page. If you scroll down, you have contestants. They are the nodes in the network. Here is the voting history. These are episodes, and I will use these episodes as the dynamic. For example, this is how we're going to use the voting history here to build our network data. If we look at the contestants here, now we have 18 contestants. This is who voted for whom in the tribal council. Emily voted Hannah, Caleb voted Hannah, Sean, Sabaya, Brandon, they all voted Hannah. In this case, all five contestants voted for the same person. So there will be co-occurrence ties that connect all five contestants. In episode two, Emily, Caleb, Sean voted for Brandon. So there are ties connecting those three contestants. Here is something interesting. In episode three, Emily and Caleb voted for Sabaya, but Sean voted for Caleb. So in this case, there is a tie connecting Emily and Caleb because they voted for the same person. But Sean voted for a different person, and there is nobody else who voted for Caleb. So in this case, Sean does not have an alliance, at least in this vote in the tribal council. Now let's look at episode five. In episode five, Austin voted for Brando. Drew voted for Brando. Emily voted for Brando. So this suggests there's three contestants, Austin, Drew, and Emily. They build an alliance in this vote. Moreover, Kendra voted Drew, Randall voted Drew. So in this case, there is a tie connecting Kendra and Brandall because they voted for the same person. This is the data that I have in spreadsheet. We have season because I want to collect the data for different seasons. And we have episode and contestants. This is what it means. In episode one, Emily, Caleb, Sean, Sabaya, and Brandon, they all voted for the same person. They all voted for Hannah. That's why I put all five of them in one cell, separated by comma. So that means they all voted for the same person. In some cases, different groups voted for a different person. For example, in episode five, Austin, Drew, and Emily, they voted for Brandon. But Kendra and Brandall voted for Drew. That's why I put them in two different rows. This suggests they have an alliance in that vote. And Kendra and Brandall had an alliance in the same vote. There is another example in episode 10, D, Austin, Drew. Let's look at episode 10. D, Austin voted for Jake. Who else voted for Jake? Drew also voted for Jake. So D, Austin, and Drew had an alliance. And Jake, Keturah, Julie, Emily voted for Bruce. That's how I build my data. These are the data that I collected from Wikipedia. Now I save this file as Voting History Season 45. Let's load the data to Gephi. To load the Excel file, in this case, we're going to need a plugin. To do so, we go to Tools, Plugins, go to Available Plugins, click Name so we can see all the plugins in alphabetical order. This is the plugin we're going to use. Select this plugin. Here you can see the description. This plugin helps you import Excel files and CSV files into Gephi by transforming them into networks, including dynamic network. That's exactly what we're trying to do right now. Click Install. Next, I accept the terms, install, restart now. We go to file, import. Now you see select a wizard. data importer, co-occurrences, that's the data we are working on, because the co-voting is actually considered as a co-occurrence in network terms. Select next, select the file, voting history, season 45. And this is the first sheet in my Excel file. The sheet name is called voting history. This is what's showing up. You can have multiple sheets in your Excel file. Next. All right. This is important. What are the connections made of? This type of agent, I want to build a tie between Emily, Caleb, Sean, Sabaya, Brandon, because they voted for the same person. I select contestants and contestants because they're in the same role. Here is an example for a network of co-authors, like co-voting. Pick the field of co-authors twice. That's what I did. Next, contestants. Is this a field made of subfields? If so, what's the delimiter? My delimiter is comma. Here, I select a comma. Next, if you want to create a dynamic network, what's the field for time? I want to use episode for time. Click next. All right, options. Create links between contestant agents and links between contestant agents. Yes, I want to use the tie or links to connect the contestants. Remove duplicates. I don't want to remove duplicates. If they vote together 7 times, that's what I want. I don't want to remove duplicates. Remove self loops. Yes, because in network analysis, self loops doesn't mean much. Next, finish. Here says, the conversion process will start when you click finish. The network will be created where contestants are connected to contestants. Finish. This, the pop-up window that shows my network is undirected, which is correct because it's a co-occurrence, co-voting. And it's a dynamic graph. That's great. We have 17 nodes. In this season, we have 18 contestants because the first person who got voted out, I think it was Hannah, she did not have an alliance, at least in this vote. That's why our network has 17 nodes. And we have 74 edges. That means we have 74 co-voting ties. Click OK. This is a network and it's a dynamic enable timeline. So this is how people voted based on different episodes. Let's look at episode number 1. I want to see the labels. Click this little button at the bottom and go to labels, go to nodes. Can we see it? Yep, we have Caleb, Emily, Brandon, Sabaya, and Sean. All of them voted for Hannah. The ties connecting Caleb, Emily, and Sean are a little bit thicker than the rest because in other votes, they voted for the same people. This is the full network. This network is difficult to read. Let's do some analysis and visualization. We calculate degree centrality and weighted degree centrality. Weighted degree centrality means in their calculation, they also include the frequency of the tie weight or the tie strength. We calculate betweenness centrality, closeness centrality, and modularity. That's the cluster or community detection. All right, we have some basics that will help us. If you go to data laboratory, you will see all the node metrics, including degree centrality, weighted degree centrality, closeness centrality, betweenness centrality, and modularity class. And we're going to use those for our network visualization. Let's first choose layout. Choose eval who, see if it works. If I remove the node labels, so we see all these people are together. Who is this node? I want to see the labels. Hide non-selected. Let's see, who is this person? That's Brando. And this cluster is Caleb, Sean, Sabaya, and Brandon. They are in a different cluster. That's because they're in a different tribe. Let me change the node color by modularity by different clusters. Here we go. See, people in different tribes tend to vote together. That's why they're in different clusters. Let me use betweenness centrality to represent the size of the nodes. I'll increase the maximum size to 40, minimum size to 10, apply. Now we see the difference here. Emily has the highest betweenness centrality. Betweenness centrality means this contestant built an alliance, at least in voting, with different groups. That's why Emily is like a bridge, bridging different clusters. And then Kendra. So Emily has the highest degree of centrality. Kendra, Jay, Kayla, they are all my favorite players in this season. What else do I need to do? I want to change the label, use regular, make it a little bit readable. Unselect height non-selected. That's still too big. Maybe size 14 will work. That's better. All right. Let me use label adjust. Now it's easy for us to read. And if we use this sliding bar, we can see in episode 1, these 5 contestants voted together. Episode 1, 2, 3, they're all in the same tribe. And then in episode 4, I think that's where they switched the tribe. Episode 5 and 6, episode 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This is the voting network in Survivor Season 45. And Emily has the highest betweenness centrality. Who has the highest degree centrality? Oh, Emily also has the highest degree centrality and weighted degree centrality, followed by Chu and followed by D. Who is the winner of the season? D is the winner. Where is Austin? Because Austin was the runner-up. Oh, Austin is right down there. How to explain that Austin was the runner-up instead of Kelly, Kendra, Bruce, Keturah, Jay, and Julie? Actually, in this season, my favorite contestants were Emily and Jake. And I think they both have high betweenness centrality. If you know how to explain Austin's network metrics and him being the runner-up in this season, feel free to leave your comments below. All right, that's how we use Wikipedia data to build the voting network by using Gephi.